Good morning, students. Hi, students. How are you? I hope you all are fine. So, before you are going to study, please pray to God for your health, your studies, your parents, education, everything. So, now we are going to study about our subject, computer science. First, take your textbooks in your hand. Please sit in front of your system or take mobile phones in your hand. Okay. So, till yesterday, you have studied about first chapter. Here discussed about what's the first chapter, introduction to computers. Are you remembering? So what's the first chapter? Introduction to computers. In the first chapter, till now, what are the topics you have discussed? So main thing is you have studied two important 5-mark questions, isn't it or not? What are the important 5-mark questions? Types of generations of computer and also functional components of a computer. Have you studied that one? Please study thorough both the questions. Write it. And again write, then only you will get, remember, please, afterwards you move to this portion. Okay, understand? Yes. Then, what are the things yesterday we have discussed? Generations of a computer. Then, what are the things? Functional components of a computer. Then, input and output devices. Just I have given introduction about input device and output device. Isn't it? Yes. Yes. So, what are the input devices yesterday you have studied? Keyboard and mouse. What are the input devices you studied yesterday? Keyboard and mouse. So today we are going to study about types of mouse. Okay. What are the things you are going to study? Types of mouse. Okay. Here there are 3 types of mouse are there. How many types of mouses are there? 3. So one by one we are going to study. Okay. So if this is a very very important 3-mark questions. Okay. If they ask for the 3-mark question, means you should draw this tabular column like that. Understood? So if they ask for this 3-mark question, means you should draw this tabular column. You should if it possible, means okay, if they ask for the 3-mark question, means you should draw this tabular column, write as a points, then only you will get full mark. Okay. So what's the first type? Means mechanical. What's the first type of a mouse? Mechanical mouse. Okay. So is it visible, this diagram? So first you see this diagram, then only you will get understand. Okay. So listen. So in mechanical mouse, so what you have seen at the center, have you seen? Is it visible? So what you have seen, this is one ball like structure is there, isn't it or not? Yes. So in mechanical mouse, what's the special feature? I mean, a small ball is kept inside. Okay, so in mechanical mouse, what's the first point which is kept inside? A small ball is kept inside. Okay, so usually you will keep the mouse, where you will keep the mouse? Have you seen? So you will keep the mouse in a small pad. You are calling that as a pad. Okay, so if you are keeping the mouse and the pad, so in this mechanical mouse, at the bottom part, one hole is there. Okay, at the bottom of the mouse, what will be present? Hole. So through that hole, this ball will touches at the bottom. Understand? So at the mechanical mouse, what is the special feature? At the center, you can able to see one ball like structure. So at the bottom, there is one hole. So this ball touches through the hole. You are placing this mouse on the pad, isn't it? Yes. So when you are moving the mouse, the ball needs to scroll. How it will work? When you are moving the mouse, how the mouse will work? You are going to move this ball. When you are moving this mouse, the ball will roll. Okay. So, while the ball is rolling, the signals is converted and send it to the computer. Okay. So, for example, you are keeping the mouse on the pad. So, you are scrolling the ball. What it will, the signals, particular electric signals is converted and that information is sent to the computer. Understand? So we have 3 points you have discussed in mechanical mouse. What are they? So in mechanical mouse, feature is, say, at the center one ball is present. So if always you will keep the mouse at the pad. So at the bottom of this mechanical mouse, you have seen on bottom one hole is there. Through that hole, this ball touches through the pad. So while you are scrolling that ball, the particular signal will be sent to the computer. Understand? Who invented this mouse, means which company, means Telefunken German company. Okay, sometimes they will ask for the one word question, which company introduced this mechanical mouse? Who? Telefunken German company. At which year? 1960. Okay. Yes. So next type of mouse is optical mouse. What's the second type? Optical mouse. Okay. So see this diagram. This is called as optical mouse. So this optical mouse. So always, what's the use of mouse? So a mouse, you can click and also scroll the ball. So the cursor will move here and there by you are clicking the mouse, isn't it? Yes. So the what's the first point is measures the motion and acceleration of your pointer. That means if you are scrolling the, for example, see. So a pointer is there or not near this mouse? One point. This is the mouse pointer. So some now I am moving this pointer here. Next I am moving. So this what is this means? Measures the motion and acceleration. Which place, from which place to which place I am moving this? So that's the first point. Okay, it will measure this motion and acceleration of your pointer. This is the pointer. Understand? Oh, okay. What's the first point? Optical mouse measures the which place you are placing this point. Understand? So here, what's the important thing means? First mechanical mouse. What's the important feature I said? Yes, ball like structure is present at the center. But here, instead of that ball, here also one center small ball is there. But instead of that ball, here which is used to judge the motion means light source. Okay, so at the bottom, if you see the optical mouse, you mean at the bottom you can see one light. That means red color or blue color, some light source will be there. Okay, so using that light instead of ball, we are using this light source to judge the motion of the pointer. That means, so I am moving this pointer from here to here. How it will judge this pointer, with this pointer placed here or this pointer placed here? How it will judge means using that light source. Understand? So at the instead of that scrolling the ball, so in this optical mouse using which source? Light source to judge the pointer. Okay, and also next thing is, in this diagram itself you can see this mouse has three buttons. How many buttons are there? Three. See, one, that's a right side, left side and center. Understand? This right side, left side and center. How many buttons are there in optical mouse? Three. What's the use means? Left click, double right click or double click. Okay, so next point is optical one less sensitive towards surface. That means only the soft surface. That means the papers or pad, only soft surface only this optical mouse will work. Understand? Four points you have discussed. What are the thing? So what's the use of optical mouse? It will measure motion and acceleration. That means this pointer, from which place the pointer is moving from here to there. Next, instead of a ball, so here it will use which one? Light source. Light source to judge which place I am pointing this one. Next, it has how many buttons are there? Three buttons are there. So, and the next point is, it is less sensitive. That means only soft surface it will work. Okay. So, which company introduced this optical mouse means? Richard Lyon Steve Krish. This version. That means this optical mouse is invented by whom? Richard Lyon Steve Krish. Okay, so he invented different versions of or different kinds of optical mouse in the year 1980. So please note it down, this and all, they will ask for this one word question. Understand? Yes. Next, third type is laser mouse. What's the third kind of mouse? Laser mouse. Okay, so here also laser mouse are the same. This one, laser mouse also, if you are using the laser mouse, the same pointer you can see in the screen if you are using laser mouse. Okay, the same point measures the motion and acceleration of a pointer. Next one, here, but what's the point? Laser mouse uses laser light. This laser mouse works based on which one? Always it is works based on laser light. Okay, so but the optical mouse, only the light signals are there, but not laser. It is work fully based on laser light, but laser mouse fully works based on which light? Which signal? Laser signal. Okay. That optical mouse is high what? Less sensitive. That means only soft surface, particular surface only we can able to move that. See, so I am keeping this mouse on the particular pad. So only it will move here and there. But laser mouse is not like that. Any hard surface you can able to use. Okay, that's the difference. Sometimes they will ask for 3 mark questions. Sometimes they will ask to differentiate between optical mouse and laser mouse. Sometimes they will ask differentiate mechanical mouse and laser mouse. So please study thorough. This is very, very important 3 mark question. Understand? Yes. So now we are studying about which device? Input device, isn't it? So we have discussed 2 input devices till now. What are they? Keyboard, mouse. So keyboard already you have studied. Mouse already you have studied. In mouse, kinds of mouse also, how many kinds of mouse you have to study? 3. What are they? Optical mouse, mechanical mouse, laser. Next, the third input device is scanner. okay, what's the next input device? Scan. Okay, before you are going to study, just look at this picture, then only you will get understand. Okay, yes. So have you seen a scanner before? See this diagram, this is the scanner. Okay, so this device always works like a Xerox machine. Okay, so what's the use of scanner? It will always works like a, so what in Xerox, what the Xerox machine will do? So if you need to take Xerox copy of your two or three papers, what they will do? They will keep the paper on the machine, then some laser light will come, then they will produce the laser, they will print particular thing, isn't it? Yes, or Xerox the particular paper. So scanner also works the same mechanism like a Xerox machine. Okay, what's the use of scanner? First, what you need to do means, see, I need to scan particular photo or I need to scan particular paper. What I need to do means, I need to keep the paper or photo inside this one, inside this place. Understand? Where I need to keep? Inside this one. So if inside this place I kept the paper or image, then I need to close the, so in region is there, no? Yeah, I need to close that one. This lid I need to close. Then after that, it will, if I closed, it will sense what are the things, if image or paper or anything. Then it will scan. Normally, what's the use of a scanning machine? Scanning. Normally, I'm telling medical field, what's the use of scan? It will scan our entire body. So internal parts, we can able to identify through this scan. Same only, if you kept this paper or some images, it means it will scan what the things you are keeping inside. It will scan and store it in the memory. Which memory? Computer memory. Understand? So what's the use of scanner? It will use to scan the particular thing and it will store the information into a computer memory. So it works like a which machine? Xerox machine. Okay, so here you can scan not only text. So here you can scan photos, images, text, what kind of papers, anything you can able to scan. Okay, so for that only there. After scanning, it will convert it in which format? Mean digital format. First day itself, I said, what are the inputs you are giving to the computer? So that input, the computer is taken as an input in the form of which format? Digital format or binary format. What is the binary format? I said, ones and zeros. Same only, what things you are scanning, mean the scanner converts the particular printed or written information or images or photographs or anything. So immediately what it will do, it will scan the particular thing and convert the particular information into which format? Digital format. Then after that, what it will do? Particular information you will store into the computer memory. Understand about scanner? Yes. So next is fingerprint scanner. What's the next scanner? Fingerprint scanner. So most of the students, you might have seen this fingerprint scanner, isn't it or not? So our school also, you have seen the fingerprint scanner, isn't it? So what's the purpose of fingerprint scanner? Already you know, I think it's so. So why they are using this fingerprint scanner means, mainly they are using for biometric. Biometric means attendance, isn't it? Attendance registration as well as security purpose. Two main purpose they are using this fingerprint scanner. What are they means? What are the two main purpose they are using? Biometrics as well as computer security. Okay, what is the meaning of biometric? For example, attendance registration. Instead of we are signing in the particular note. So at what time you are coming or what time you are going. That and all recorded by using fingerprint. So what is the use of a thumb? So we will keep our thumb in the place of which one? Have you seen a green color portion is there? Yes. In that place, you need to keep our thumb. So it will detect our thumb impression. So thumb impression, it will detect based on that. It will send the signals and store that particular our information and it will which time you are coming. And particular information is recorded in your memory. Understand? Whether two persons have the same thumb impression? Whether it is possible? No. So each individual have separate and different thumb impressions. So this what's the use of a fingerprinter? Mainly it is used for biometric, that means attendance by that registration technique, as well as computer security. So have you, most of the films have you seen lockers and all, they will, so at the in front of the locker they are giving some passwords or fingerprint scanner. So immediately they will keep their fingerprint, the locker will open. So that's important, isn't it? That's one of the most important security technique, because no two persons have same thumb impression. So our thumb impression, if we give, means so particular lock will be very, very secure. So not only that lockers, even our mobile phones also fingerprint scanner is there. Have you seen it? Fingerprint scanner. If we give the fingerprint scanner, means the particular lock will come. Only that person alone open that particular mobile. Okay, what's the use of fingerprint scanner? So it will mainly used for two purposes. What are they? Biometric technology as well as computer security. Okay, so instead of using, what they are telling me, instead of, for security purpose, we are telling, no, security purpose, it is very useful. Instead of using password, whether it is safe and security, I am asking. It is better than password, isn't it, Anna? Password, sometimes in our mobile phones, most of the mobile phones, we are giving passwords, isn't it? Why? Third person not able to open the mobile phone. For that, we are giving passwords. Suppose the third person can able to see the password, means next time, he or she will open immediately. But if I are giving my fingerprint, means whether particular third persons can open? No. Isn't it? Yes. So we can, for security purpose, protect from third person also. We are, instead of using passwords, you are using fingerprint reader or scanner. Understand? Yes. See this. This is the diagram for fingerprint scanner. Understand? Yes. Next one is trackball. Okay. What's the next input device? Till now we have discussed about what are the input devices. Keyboard, mouse, types of mouse, then scanner, fingerprint scanner. Okay. Next one is trackball. Okay. So see this diagram. This is the trackball. Okay. So this is just like a mouse. Same. If the diagram, if you have seen, means same, it just like a mouse. But what's thing means? What's if you are usage of mouse, you are moving the mouse from here to there, the pointer also move here. Just scrolling the ball, then left click, double click, that and all. What's the thing mean here? We are keeping the mouse, that means a particular device as a stationary. That means the device we are keeping in a particular place, the device won't move, but we are scrolling the ball alone. Understand? So the device itself stationary, that means the device you are keeping stationary, one place we are keeping the device in front of the computer. Only we are scrolling the bar. Okay. Upside and downside we are scrolling the bar. Okay. So this ball can spin various directions. So based on the direction, the pointer can move from here and there. Understand? So what's the use of this one? Trackball is similar to mouse. But what's the thing? Mouse, the whole the mouse or device, you can move from here and there. But trackball, we are keeping the device as stationary in one place. When we are moving only this part, that means this is the trackball. This is trackball. Okay. This ball alone we are moving. So based on that, the scrolling, the user, this if we spin this ball, means we can able to the in screen the movements, that particular pointer will move from here to there based on this spin movement. Understand now? Yes. Next input device is retinal scanner. Okay. This you can, already you have seen. This device already you have seen. Where? Are you remembering? Are you remembering where you can see this device? Yes, all of you have other cards, isn't it? So for taking other card, what are the things they will do? Fingerprint they have taken. Fingerprint scanner also already we have studied, no? Yes. What are the things they have taken? Fingerprint scanner. So fingerprint also you have taken. Next one is retinal scanner. What they will do, retinal scanner? They will scan our eyes. Isn't it? Scan our eyes. Like a thumb impression, this retinal, no two persons have same retinal impressions. Okay, like a thumb impression, no two persons have same retinal impressions. Okay, retinal scanner is used to, for what? Scan our retinal part of our eyes. That means retinal part, inside our retina blood vessels are there, person's retinal blood vessels, it will scan. And mainly it is used to for biometric technique. Okay, biometrics, so other card purposes also they are using to scan what? Our fingerprint as well as retinal. Understand what's the use of retinal? So it will scan our, that means in the retinal part of our eye, it will scan the blood vessels present inside the retinal. Mainly this use for what? Which technique? Biometric technique. Understand? Yes. Next thing is light pen. Okay, light pen. See this diagram. Before you are going to study that theory, so all the things are available in your textbook. Please don't skip anything. Please study. Okay. So from this, mostly they will ask for 1 mark, 2 mark, sometimes they will ask for 5 mark also. Please don't skip anything. Listen and study. So before you are going to study the theory, first you look at the diagram and study. Then you won't get forget. Okay. See, light pen. So this is the light pen. So have you seen the pen-like structure here? Yes. So what's the use of this light pen? This is a pointing device. Okay. What's the name? This is light pen. Light pen is a pointing device. That means, so here the at the end, one cable is there, no? We can able to connect this cable at the monitor. Okay, by this pin we can able to connect this pin to the monitor. What's the use of this means? So in schools we can see the smart board is there. You might have seen, I think it's so before 4 or 5 years before, smart boards, they have given one pen. Have you seen it, that pen? So like in tip one small pen like structure, you can able to write using that pen, you can able to write in the smart board. Have you seen it? Same like only, okay, light pen. So light pen is similar to that only. It is a pointing device. That's like a pen like structure. So you can able to connect this pen to this monitor. Okay. So what's the use of this pen means? You can able to write simply you are writing. For example, using pen you are writing notes. In a notes you are writing. In a pencil you can draw this picture. Same thing, by using this pen you can draw or write anything in the particular surface on the screen. For example, this is a screen. Okay, so now I need to write something on the screen. Okay, whether with this pen or pencil, whether I can able to write on the screen? No. So in that thing, so this using this light pen, I can able to write or draw something on this screen using which device? Light pen. So how it will work means, see, this is the tip or pointing, that a tip portion, one small sensor like that, means tip contains small light. Okay, that's the name itself having light pen. So light sensitive element is there, present in the front of the pen. Okay, so while you are writing on the screen, so the through that light the signals is detected through the computer. Okay, so for example, consider this is a light pen. So I am writing on the screen. Okay, so I am going to writing on the screen. So at the tip portion, what I said, one pointing device or lighting is there. So if I touch this pen to there, this light will blink. So that signal will get through this cable and send it to the computer. So through that computer will identify, so I am writing this point or this position on the screen. Understand what's the use of light pen? What's the use of light pen? Used to draw or write or something on the screen. Okay, so but it is very very hard to use. Okay, sometimes the position, if you are changing the position, means you can't able to write properly. So that's a disadvantage of this pen. Okay, so light pen is if you are looking, means the just like a pen like structure. So at the end one cable is there, you need to connect this part of the pin to this this cable, connect this cable to the computer. So what's the use of this? You are writing something on this screen, means it is at the end tip, one pointing device is there. From that pointing device light will come, through that light the sends the signal and the computer can identify you are writing something in this screen. Understand? Yes. Next thing is optical character reader. Okay, this is similar to this scanner. Okay, already you have studied, no? Scanner similar. Okay, likewise this is what, optical character reader. So this is the diagram, or this is a picture of which one? Optical character reader. Okay, so what's the use of this one means? That's a full form, OCR. OCR means optical character reader. Okay, what's the use of this means? You can able to detect particular characters printed or written on a paper. For example, I have one paper. In that paper fully I have written some notes, or I have written 10 lines. So I need to scan only 5 lines alone. So at that time I'm using which one? This optical character reader. Okay, you can able to scan a full page from a book also, or you can able to detect particular characters from that book. What do you mean by character? So this one, COMPUTER. This is, we are telling us, and what, C is one character, O is one character, M is one character. This is the character. Understand? So you can able to character each character by character, which device? Optical character reader used to scan or detect what are the things you have written on the paper. That means what are things, whether it is printed or you are written notes or anything. Now our full page you can also able to scan using which device? Optical character reader. Okay, so not only it will detect characters, it will detect letters, symbols, punctuation marks, everything. Okay, so it will scan the particular document and store in a memory. Okay, after that, if you need to edit the particular document, means so in the computer you can able to edit the document using which one? Word, MS Word or MS Excel or PowerPoint or anything. Understand what's the use of optical character reader? It's a device used to detect what particular scanner, means it will scan only full paper or full page. But here you can able to detect or scan particular what characters printed on a paper or what when the printed paper or your written notes or anything, or you can able to scan full book, mean full book. Okay, so it will scan letters, symbols, punctuation marks, everything you can able to scan using which device? Optical character reader. So and also all the things are scanned and stored in a memory. If you need to edit the document, means you can able to pin it on the computer and you can able to edit using which processor? Word processor. Understand? Next one is barcode or QR code reader. This already you might have seen in what lot of malls, huge malls you have seen, means most of this malls having this barcode reader. Yeah, okay, so what do you mean by barcode reader? Have you seen even the pen itself having barcode? Like most of the pen, then all the things, all the stationery things, anything if you bought from the store, means each and everything has a what? Barcode. Have you seen it barcode? So silver color lines. So have you seen the silver color with the silver color paper, black lines are there. That is called as what? Barcode. Okay. So what do you mean by barcode? It is a pattern of printed in lines. Whether all the lines are same thickness. Have you seen the barcode? If you seen the barcode, means not all the lines have the same thickness. Each and every line will be different thickness, will be of different thickness. Okay. So what's the use of this barcode reader? Means the, if you press the particular in front of that barcode reader, so if you, it will first, it will scan the particular barcode. What it will do with barcode reader? So if you are, for example, this pen I have particular barcode, what I will do, if I kept this pen in front of this barcode, mean first it will scan. So scan the barcode, so that means each and every line has particular information from which company particular this pen belongs, who is handling this one, like this. Okay, so this barcode, if the device scan this particular thing, and it will send the information to the whom? Computer for processing. So it will send the information to the computer. The computer, you can able to identify from which company it will produce. Okay, understand? So what's the use of the barcode? For example, if it is not match, means particular barcode, so each and every if a company is producing a particular barcode, means if you scan barcode reader scan, means surely it will give the from this company I am giving supplying this barcode this pen to this mall. So if it is a fraud, means so surely it will give an error message, so this is a wrong, this is a not a valid product. That's the use of barcode reader. Understand? So what's the use of barcode? Barcode is, if you see the barcode, means it is a pattern of printed lines. So each and every line is of different thickness. Not each line will be of same thickness. So if the barcode reader will scan the particular lines, so immediately it will scan, they send the information to the computer or transmit the particular signals to the computer for processing. So this system gives you, if it correct, means it will give, yeah, it will detect and give this okay, the signal is okay, this barcode is correct. So if it is a wrong, means it will give error free end. Understand? Yeah. Next one is a QR code reader. Okay, what's the meaning of QR code? Quick response code. What is QR? Quick response code. Okay, so this is a two-dimension barcode. What is the QR code? Two-dimension barcode. Have you seen the barcode? This is a QR code. So in your textbook also there. So I have shown this diagram. See, this is the barcode. QR code. Sorry, not barcode. QR code. Understand now? Have you seen it? So this is a two-dimensional. This is a QR code. QR response. Understand? Yes. Likewise, each and everything nowadays having what? QR code. Okay, this is a two-dimension barcode. What's a QR code? It is a two-dimension barcode. So this can be read by a camera. Okay, so for example, So if I have shown no, this QR code, so immediately if a net connection is there, means in front of this camera, if I say means that in using the net, it will scan. Okay, scan that image and it will give the particular information. Understand what's a QR code? QR code is a two-dimension code. What it will do? First, it will scan the particular image. So scan the particular image and process that image, and it will give the proper information. Understand? So how many readers are studied? Barcode reader and QR reader. What's the use of barcode reader? It will used to identify which part this product belong to, which one and which one. Okay, so this barcode, the thickness will be of different, so each and every line the thickness need not be a same. Okay, the lines will be of different thickness. What the barcode will do? The barcode first scan the particular thing, so and it send the information to whom? Computer for processing. So if the information is correct, means it will send it.